So let's look at the Meike 85mm f2.8 macro lens that goes from infinity to 1.5x magnification. And it covers full frame and it comes for basically every mount under the sky. If you have an interchangeable lens camera, it probably comes for your camera. I got a very cheap first impression. This bag that comes with it feels like a mixture of like plastic and paper, and the lens itself is wrapped in something that is similar to a cheap garbage bag. But I have to say that the lens itself at least feels pretty high quality, although it smells like a whole tire factory of the rubber on the rubber rings for focusing. And that's a real peculiarity with this lens. I would love to hear the story behind it, but it has two focusing rings. One to focus until 1x magnification and the other one to 1.5x magnification. Very interesting design. Yeah, but other than that, the lens feels very well built. It feels it will last for a while. So except for the smelly rubber focusing rings, the whole lens is made out of metal and glass, obviously. And yeah, I like the feel of it otherwise. The focusing rings felt slightly awkward in the beginning, like they didn't feel that smooth, but after some use, they started feeling more and more smooth. So they are completely okay. When I took my first test shots, I quickly discovered that the lens is sharp, but it has some problems with chromatic aberration. You can see some purple fringing here in this photo. But for me, the way I judge a lens or any type of equipment is that I use it as I normally would use any lens and see what kind of results I get and compare them with other results and see if I'm happy about them. So that's what I'm gonna do now. So first of all, the lens is obviously completely manual. It has no electrical contacts or anything like that. And that is nothing you would expect from such a cheap lens. This lens is around $240. So in that sense, this is probably the cheapest macro lens you can get that covers full frame and that goes from infinity to 1.5x magnification. So if the image quality is good, this is quite a bargain. And I'm here to tell you that the image quality is very good. Except for that purple fringing that you can see in some situations, although very slightly. This lens performs really, really great. This is very sharp. Look at the ant's eye here. This is at like f8. And like I didn't notice any other problems with the optics. It takes beautiful photos and yeah, it works well. Most of the test shots in this video I took at aperture f8 with an ISO of 100 and with my Meike flash. This flash is actually made for Fuji cameras, but it works great on my Sony a7 III camera that I used. Many of the photos I touched up slightly in Lightroom, although not a lot, and I also cropped some of them a little bit. But other than that, I didn't touch them that much. So to show you the sharpness at f2.8, here is one sample shot. Someone forgot their glasses in the forest, and as you can see, it is very sharp at 200%. When I'm out photographing and looking for good subjects, meaning mostly insects to photograph, I can quite often find myself walking around looking a lot and not finding anything at all. And if you're in this situation, the best thing to do is always to move to a new area, because insects tend to flock in very small areas, according to my experience. So you might just need to walk a couple of hundred meters, which is what I did here. And then I found so many insects in a very, very small area. So that is a tip for you. Like if you spend 10-15 minutes and don't find anything in a certain area, just walk somewhere else and try again. There is no point staying anywhere where you're not finding any insects. Apparently it's a place where insects don't like to hang around. And very often when I'm out walking, which I usually do for like 1.5 hours, I find myself taking like 80% of the good photos in an area of maybe 2x2 meters. Often it's just a plant or a bush or something that has so many interesting subjects. So yeah, that's an interesting thing and something to take with you when you go out to do some freehand macro photography. So this lens, I really like it. For $240, it's a really good purchase, I would say. If you have a restrained budget and you want a real macro lens, this could be a really good option. If you only have around $250 to spare, I think this is a good purchase. Obviously, the optics are not flawless, but they are good. And there aren't that many situations where you will actually notice the problems with purple fringing. As you can see here, it is very, very sharp, even for like normal day-to-day photography. And even though the focus throw is not really optimized for that, I found that it works pretty well. Although, as you can see, it doesn't handle direct sunlight very well. Otherwise, it is great for all-round photography or for taking shots of your family or whatever. Here is another test shot at f2.8, and yeah, it's sharp. What else can I say? Here is another one at high magnification at f2.8. And look at the ant eye. Looks sharp. Definitely on the same level as most other macro lenses that f2.8 at full magnification. Yeah, here is another shot at f2.8, and have a look at the eyes of the butterfly. Nothing to complain about whatsoever. When I'm out walking, trying to find good subjects to photograph, I almost only look in comfortable heights so that when I do find insects, I only find them in places where I can actually find good angles to photograph them. You never see me like crawling around on the ground, because even if I would find an insect to photograph there, it would be so hard to get a good angle, so I just don't bother with that. And so that might be a tip for you if you are as lazy as me. And here you see what I mean by that certain places have a lot of insects. I mean, this bush or plant or whatever you wanna call it, this is just a small part of it. And as you can see, there are at least 10 different insects sitting on here, and there are new ones coming in all the time. So you can find these places if you're lucky and if you walk around for a while, and then you can just stay there for a long time and take many nice shots. Usually a place like this, like a meadow with lots of wildflowers, is a really good place to look. Here is an Italian striped bug. I love photographing these. Unfortunately, I didn't get like super nice shots of it because it wasn't really in focus enough. But they are great fun to photograph because they are not that skittish. So, what's my final verdict about the Meike 85mm f2.8 1.5 time to infinity macro lens? For the money, $240, it's a great purchase. And it goes to 1.5 times magnification, which is more than many other macro lenses. If I only had $250 to spare and wanted to buy a macro lens, this would be my recommendation. This is what I would get. But if you have like $400, $450 to spare, I would probably look at the Lauva lenses instead, because they go to 2x magnification and they have better optics with no purple fringing at all. And also they don't smell like a rubber tire factory. Other than that, for the money, I think it's hard to beat the Meike lens. I really like it. I'm gonna leave you here with a couple of shots at f2.8 again. And please don't forget to subscribe to my photography newsletter. It's filled with inspiration, comes out once a month. You can find it over at mwroll.com. Goes on up there. And don't forget to like this video if you did like it. It helps this channel a lot. And also, please do subscribe. I post new videos on macro photography every week. Over and out. Bye.